Hello everyone, I am Rohit Kumar Thakur and today I am excited to show you how to download media files including images and videos from Firebase storage using React Native Expo application. But first, check out the demo of the project on your screen. Now let's dive into the process. Start by creating an Expo application and select the blank template. Name your application and continue with downloading the dependencies. To make this project work, we need to install a few packages using npm. So let's go ahead and install them one by one. Moving on, open the project and you will notice that we are using the latest version of each package in this project. As we are using Firebase in this project, we need to make a config file that contains all the Firebase config keys. If you are new to setting up Firebase for React Native Expo, no worries, follow the instruction in the video or you can skip ahead if you already know how to set it up. Don't forget to initialize Firebase storage. In this project, we are using test mode, but if you are planning to push your app in production, make sure to choose the production mode and check the rules. Select the storage location according to your preference and wait a few seconds. After that, you can upload the file you want to store in the Firebase storage. Here, we will only be uploading media files, but you can also create folder inside the Firebase storage. Now, we are all set to write some code. First, we are importing various components and libraries that we will be using in this app. Next, we are defining a functional component named app. This component will contain all the logic and UI for our app. Inside app, we are using the useState hook to create a state variable called MediaData. This state variable will hold an array of objects, where each object represents a media file stored on Firebase storage. We are initializing MediaData to an empty array. We are also using the useEffect hook to fetch MediaData from Firebase storage when the component mounts. Inside the useEffect hook, we are defining an asynchronous function called getMediaData. This function fetches references to all media files from Firebase storage, gets their download URLs and metadata, and stores this information in an array of objects. We are using the promise.all method to fetch download URLs and metadata for all media files in parallel. Once all the promises are resolved, we are updating the MediaData state variable with an array of objects containing media information. Next, we are defining another asynchronous function called downloadFile. This function takes three parameters: URL, filename, and isVideo. URL is the download URL for the media file, filename is the name of the file, and isVideo is a boolean value indicating whether the media file is a video or an image. Inside downloadFile, we are first requesting permission to access the device's media library using the medialibrary.requestPermissionsAsync method. If the permission is not granted, we are displaying an alert message asking the user to grant permission. Once we have permission, we are using the filesystem.createDownloadResumable method to download the media file from the given URL and save it to the device's cache directory. We are setting sudcache to false to prevent the file from being cached, as we are not going to use it again. Once the download is complete, we are using the video thumbnails.getThumbnailAsync method to generate a thumbnail for videos. We are setting the time property to 1000 to generate a thumbnail from the video's first second. Finally, we are using the MediaLibrary.createAssetAsync method to save the downloaded media to the device's media library. We are logging the URI of the downloaded media file and the URI of the generated thumbnail to the console. I am using console.log statements frequently because this helps me to debug the application quickly. Now in return statement, we are rendering a view component that contains a text component with the title name and a list of media files along with a download button for each file. We are using the map method to loop over the media data array and render a view component for each media file. Inside each view component, we are rendering either an image or video component based on whether the media file is an image or video. Great, we are almost done with our application, but before we wrap up, let's add some basic styling to make it more appealing. Now that our application is ready, let's test it out. You may notice a type error when you click on the download image button, but don't worry, we will fix it together. To fix the error, we simply need to modify the spelling of request permission async to request permissions async. After saving the file, test the application again, and you should see on the console screen that our media file is downloaded in the DCIM folder of the internal storage. Let's check that out. In addition to downloading images, we can also download the other media files like videos. However, we are currently seeing an error in the alert statement. I tried to fix it a few times but couldn't quite get it right. If you manage to fix the error, please let me know in the comment section. But don't worry, the error in the alert statement is not crucial to the functionality of the application, so I decided to remove it. Now that we have everything working smoothly, that's it for this video. I hope it met your expectations and provided you with the valuable insights into React Native. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on React Native, where we will explore various aspects of this fantastic framework in more detail.